everybody, welcome back to my channel. Happy Rocktober! If you guys are new here, welcome. You're probably here because you are a Junji Ito fan, an anime fan, or you're looking for something to do this Halloween that's gonna be quick and easy and low skill level. This is the tutorial for you. So my name is M Sakura. I'm from the cast of season 12, RuPaul's Drag Race. I love horror manga. I love dressing up. And this Halloween, I decided to do a Junji Ito look inspired by Junji Ito's Uzumaki. So 2 years ago, I did a Junji Ito look. I did Slug Girl right over here. If you guys want to watch it, we'll put a link in the description. Anyways, this is a look I've been wanting to do for a long time. If you guys are gonna do something for Halloween that just requires a lot of paper, foam board, or if you want something that maybe you can work on for an anime convention that might be pretty cool, but pretty easy. I would say it's pretty easy. Anyways, before we get into the video today, please make sure to like this video. Of course, if you love Junji Ito like I do, I love that man so much. Comment down below, what is your favorite Junji Ito story? My favorite story is... Oh my god, there's so many good ones. I really like the floating heads. I really, really, really like the floating heads. It's one of the ones that actually got me into the whole series. And of course, Tomie. Love Tomie. The gays love Tomie. Oh, let's get into the video.
Hi, it's Voiceover Rock here. First things first. I sectioned the hair to where I want my foam board. I just got a black one from Staples. Then I measured about how big I want the arch to be on my head. Then, I traced out the hair using a reference from the manga panel. And after I tried it on, I cut everything out with a razor blade.
That looks so good. That is exactly what the concept is, huh? You got it shaped perfect.
I glued the wig onto the base and combed the hair up using wood glue. And got to be. A lot of got to be. It was a lot of got to be. This was definitely the hardest part of the whole project. While the hairpiece was drying, I painted on some shadows and lines onto my top. And then, while that was drying, I used white paint over the hair and board that was glued into one piece. Again, I used a reference for this part.
Now that we've done all of that preparation, everything is drying. By the way, if you have wet paint, don't go to a convention. Wait till it dries and then you go, because everyone else has worked much harder on their cosplays than you. And to get it ruined by wet paint would be devastating. Let's go ahead and get into the makeup. First things first, let's go ahead and glue down our eyebrows. I just used this purple Elmer's glue stick on my eyebrows. I did like big circles, and then I combed it through with this fine tooth comb to the side. Whichever way the hair was going, I glued it down that way, and I made it flat. I also did my sideburns too. I'm gonna do my last layer. So I already did two, and I let it dry in between. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna place my last layer of glue stick here. And then I have white powder right now because we are doing white makeup. I'm gonna take a large powder puff. This is a powder puff that is not, it does not look like a shaggy dog. I'm gonna dip it into my powder and I'm gonna get a fair amount of powder on there, like a fair amount. I'm gonna be very clean right now and I'm gonna do this over my powder. I'm gonna lightly press it. If you don't have enough product, you're gonna stick to the powder puff, so just add more when you run out. But once everything is dry, you can just brush it off with a large powder brush if you have it. And then when it's dry, take your primer, whatever primer you're using, because you are using primer. And if you guys don't know what kind of primer to use or to buy, if you're new to this, we just made a video a couple weeks ago where we give you a list on products that you can try if you're just starting out in drag this year for Halloween. Okay, it's dry. I'm gonna add primer on. That's a lot of primer. You know how many, well, the last time I did the Junji Ito makeup, I had white in my ears and it was still there 3 days later. Now that my face is primed, everything is glued down, it's all dry. Time for us to get started on our makeup. So whatever white makeup you have, this 00 from Krylon, it's a TV paint stick. It's not the most white foundation I have, but I'm running out of my white that I normally use. So we're gonna be using this one and setting it with a more white powder. When you look like an absolute freak and you're covered with white, it's time to blend everything out. I'm gonna use a beauty blender and I'm just gonna blend everything. So this Halloween season, if you've never read a horror manga, I would definitely suggest reading Junji Ito. So if you guys have been on my channel, I always rave about Junji Ito. He's one of my favorite manga artists. Like, the artist himself has a light and airy and nice personality, but his stuff is very dark. It's a lot of main characters being thrust into these situations that are so surreal to them. And a lot of people say that his stuff has social commentary, which a lot of them feel like they do. But sometimes he's just like, I wanted to make a spooky story about a chair. If I have any suggestions for Junji Ito stories, I would suggest Slug Girl. Definitely read the entirety of Tomie. Recently, in the last few years, Junji Ito has been adapted into English anthologies through Viz Media. Shout out to Viz. Hey, very white. It's kind of like, okay, anyways. I'm gonna take this white powder, this is like clown white powder. The powder that I used before was translucent powder, which means that it's clear. This is painted white. So we're gonna want to use a fair amount of this. What I like to do is I like to like dust over everything really quick just so that my makeup sponge doesn't stick to it later. And then once the initial dusting is finished, then I'll pack on a bit more where I need it. Okay, so we're gonna be doing a black and white look. What you wanna do is you wanna have a general reference of where you wanna get to. I'm gonna be using this image right here, but I'm gonna do a little bit more artistic interpretation. I wanna have it black and white, but I do want a little bit of depth. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna work around my eyes for a little bit of a crease moment. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make an implied line. I'm gonna take that shadow and then I'm just gonna smoke it. And with a lot of this stuff that I'm doing right now, I'm gonna go back in a second and add a stark black line to it to make it more cohesive with the manga. And this is just gonna imply a little bit of depth, add a little bit more depth to our face. So her face in the reference that I'm using is very just plain. We're gonna go in and do a little bit more subtle lines. So we're gonna start with the bottom of the nose. I'm gonna take this black shadow again. And I'm gonna make a upside down triangle from where the point of my nose is to my nostrils, just like that. And then I'm gonna take it and I'm gonna fill it in. Now be careful at this point not to get any fallout on the white because it will gray it up. And now I'm gonna take a little bit of the black, but then I'm gonna wipe some of it off so that I only have a little bit left on my brush. And then I'm gonna do a nose contour. Now the image that I have, she doesn't have too much of a nose. Actually, she doesn't really have a nose in general, but I am a three-dimensional person and I want to add a little bit of a contour. And on one side, cause I'm gonna go more for a manga feel, on one side, I'm gonna go darker with my line and deeper. And the other one's gonna be shorter, more implied that I'm facing this direction. Eyebrows. I'm gonna try to find the best place to place them. I think it should be right here. For most eyebrows, it's pretty deep right at the beginning. You'll notice that with this makeup, I'm gonna take a lot more liberties in doing it than I did last time with Slug Girl. So this one, what's more important is the headpiece and the kind of whole demeanor of the whole entire outfit. Also too, you're in a full outfit this time. This isn't just for an Instagram picture. Someone sawing outside? In the hall? Weird. Next, I'm gonna take this black and I'm going to go around my eye. You see how I kind of made like a little liner right here, but I didn't use the liquid liner? This is more like getting the shape of everything. So it's almost like when you're doing a pencil sketch, this is like the initial sketch layer. And then once I get everything the way I want it, then I'm gonna go over it with inks. I'm gonna take this black and I'm gonna upturn the side of my lips. And then I'm going to place some on my lips. eyeshadow on the lips does not feel good. Okay, now what's really prominent in black and white inking is doing a shadow underneath your bottom lip. So I'm gonna show you how I would do it if I was illustrating this right now. So I'm gonna take my black, I'm gonna go underneath my regular lip, I'm gonna line the bottom, I'm gonna make a little bit of a crescent shape underneath. That's where the shadow would normally fall. I'm gonna fill that in. And now I wanna imply my top lip. So I'm just gonna do the same thing like I did here in the corner, here at the bottom. I'm gonna place it right where it's gonna be the deepest shade. Just like this. I'm gonna wipe off the excess and then I'm gonna blend this out. Okay, I'm gonna add a little bit more black to the nose just so that it kind of looks like I'm turned to the side a little bit more. And what you can do is if you don't have any liner, which who knows, you only have black shadow, you can take your brush, if it's like a detail one, and you can just kind of fan from here. If you want to do a pretty version of this look, which is the reference that we're doing right here, you can stop right here. You know what, I'm also, if you're doing the pretty look, add a little bit of lines like this. It'll help define your face. One, but I'm going to show you how to go from here into a more deepened, maddened version of the girl. Like I was saying in the story, the hair just takes everything out of this girl. It really sucks her dry. Sucks her dry, mama. If you're new here, I'm not even gonna explain it. I'm gonna take my shadow and I'm gonna make my cheeks more hollow. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to make a fake cheekbone right here. And then I'm going to, instead of going straight down, I'm gonna angle it towards the bottom of this lip muscle right here. And then I'm gonna take a little bit of shadow and I'm gonna drag it downwards. Kind of get this hollow look from it right there. Just like that. Her eyes are like real sunken in at this point because she's sucked dry. So again, we're gonna add a little bit of bags right here. And I'm gonna concentrate most of the product right here towards the inner corner. I'm not gonna touch the eye, but I'm gonna get close. And I'm gonna bring it down. Junji Ito really makes it, his black and whites purposeful. They look very impactful. I don't think he uses screen tones too much in his earlier work, so it's just black and white ink. So we're gonna go for a very stark eye look. I'm gonna put a fair amount of black around my eye and blend it up, blend it down, bulging inwards. So I'm gonna just use some lines right here to define that. So essentially what we're doing is we're trying to like highlight our bone structure, and by bone structure I mean our bones. Like she is supposed to be drained. Maybe a little bit of brow furrow because she's really straining. Her cheeks right here, she starts to get a little bit more of a line in between. So we're gonna add a little bit right there. Now, I've done a fair amount of kind of like blocking and shadowing. So what I'm gonna do after this step is I'm going to take my black liner that I have and I'm going to go over some of these lines almost with the intention that I'm drawing a manga. I'm gonna take a fine tip liner. You can also use a liquid liner if you want, depending on what part of the face you're gonna use. I'm gonna start off with just going over the darkest points that I wanna go into. And literally for this makeup tutorial, all you really need is black liner, white cream, white powder. You can even use talcum powder if you wanna set it with talcum powder. You'll smell like a baby's bottom, but you'll still be set. I'm gonna line my eyes. I can do it pretty sloppily actually because her eyes are gonna be like really distressed. One thing I like to do is if I have a character that's like really like drained or is dark looking or scary, I'm gonna add lateral lines. Just like if I was shading a manga, I'm gonna add lateral lines around the eyes basically what I'm doing here is I'm trying to get a little bit of drama around my eye. And I'm also gonna add some of those lines here at the cheek, just to also imply that they are going hollow. I think we're almost there. So once I'm done with all of this black, I'm gonna go back in with my white liner and I'm gonna define some of those lines that I lost in my shading before. Just like last year with Slug Girl. So this isn't in my reference, but I'm gonna use it in this year too. I'm gonna use the same technique. I'm gonna take some black. This is like water activated liner. And I'm gonna take a pretty stiff brush so I can go like this. I'm gonna take a lot of water on my brush, place it in here. It's like a nice watery consistency. Flick it onto my eyes with my eye closed. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna add a little bit of extra, almost like screen tone drama. I really want these eyes to pop out at you. Now, I'm going to add my contacts. I'm gonna add my lashes. And then I'm gonna do my hands and get the whole outfit on, and I will be right back with you guys. See you in a second.
See you in a second.
And you hate you.
Like the slightest bit of wind pulls everything. It's nuts. Here's the final look, everybody. Oh my God, I'm ready for Halloween. Is it ooky? Is it spooky? Is it Miss Junji Ito drag pun? This is the finished look. I am so proud of this look. I did all of this in one night. The shirt and the skirt were $5 each. The wig was the most expensive thing on this whole thing. The wig cost, I would say, maybe $35. The foam board was like $10. The paint we already had. So it's a pretty inexpensive look if you already have a lot of the materials. But I love this look. I have been wanting to do this look for so long. You have no idea how long I've been wanting to do this look. And the fact that it turned out. It turned out so well. Oh my God, this looks so, oh, I feel so pretty. If you do this look, please make sure to tag me. Please make sure to show me pictures if you even try or attempt to do this. For me, it was relatively easy to do this look. Try it with your skill set. Depending on how long you've been doing cosplay or hair or makeup, whatever, it should be relatively easy. It's just black and white makeup. I say that. But black and white makeup can be hard. But if you do anything like this, please make sure to tag yourself. So happy Rocktober, everybody. We also have lots of videos for the rest of October. There's lots of different videos. We're gonna link them down there. You might see them floating around. There's tons of amazing, amazing treats for you guys this Rocktober. So please make sure to enjoy all of our content. Like this video if you use this tutorial at any time, or if you just liked seeing the whole process of going through the whole outfit. Subscribe to this channel if you want more content just like this, ring the bell for notifications, and of course, comment down below. I asked you before, which Junji Ito story is your favorite, and if you're just starting to read it, what did you start out with? You guys, thank you so much for watching this video. To all of my amazing patrons on Patreon, we couldn't do any of this without you guys. You help sponsor this channel and keep us going strong. If you guys want to support us too, there's a link in the description below for you to become a patron today, where you get lots of perks, but the best perk of all is supporting this channel and helping us make amazing art like this. Bye! With that, I'm gonna say, woo, talk to you later. Woo.